And also this morning, a lot of questions about a so-called incarceration room uncovered at McAuliffe International School in Denver. School board members calling for investigations to determine how that room was actually used.
Let's get right to Fox 31's Vicente Arenas, who has continuing coverage this morning. And Vicente, you talk with that whistleblower. No doubt a lot of questions, and this comes as the principal there was recently fired.
We have been talking to them, and it was a bit of a surprise when that news conference was called here at DPS headquarters yesterday. We didn't know exactly what was going to be mentioned. And then we heard the word incarceration room, and we're like, what's that? Let's show you some pictures and video of what we're talking about here. The whistleblower described the incarceration room at McAuliffe International School. Photos and videos showing locks on doors and windows in room 121E. DPS School Board Vice President Ayante Anderson said an anonymous employee at the school sent him an email about this room saying that students of color had been locked up in that room. We're told there were even holes in the drywall where it's believed that angry students punched holes in that wall. They had been locked up in that room, we are told. This new information coming as the board is set to vote on whether to uphold the termination of the school principal, Kurt Dennis. School Board Vice President Anderson described the room as a prison. Now, district policy strictly prohibits what are described as seclusion rooms. There are concerns now about possible systemic racism at the school.
Right now, we have an investigation that we are currently undergoing to ensure, to figure out who was knowledgeable of said room, if students, when students were in this room, were they alone? There are a lot of things that we're still investigating.
I think based on the evidence we have in front of us and based on what the whistleblower has provided to us, absolutely. The whistleblower says clearly this is students of color who were placed into this environment. And if that's not systemic oppression, I'm not sure what is.
We're told the lock was removed from the door after a work order was submitted by a school employee citing room needed some repairs. And that's when it was taken off. The principal, Kurt Dennis, was fired after speaking to a news outlet about district policy involving administrators that had been searching students after a shooting had occurred at another school. So this morning, there are a lot of questions about this incarceration room. The district refers to them as seclusion rooms. The word incarceration came from how the employee described that room. So a lot of questions about how did we get there, how many students were in there, and what happens next. And if other employees were involved, what should happen to them? Reporting live from DPS headquarters downtown Denver, I'm Vicente Arenas, Fox 31. Back to you guys in the studio.
So we know the locks are no longer there, so more people found out about this and then removed the locks, and now there's an investigation?
Apparently what we're hearing, I talked to this whistleblower through an email yesterday. What I'm being told that at different times there were other employees that would even at times hold the door shut. And it was a bolt latch door that where they would bolt it from the outside and whoever was inside would not be able to be out. So according to the whistleblower, there were other staff members at the school that knew that this room existed. So a lot of questions this morning, guys.
All right, and I don't know if you know the answer to this. When I was in elementary school, we had a cool-down seclusion room like this, but that was 40 years ago, and that was in the 80s. Times have changed, obviously. Do we know, Vicente, if this is something that they possibly have at other schools in the district?
During the news conference yesterday, it was mentioned that there are so-called de-escalation rooms. Mm-hmm. It is a specific term, de-escalation.
Right.
But in the de-escalation rooms, it was described that there are bean bags. It's a cool-down room. There are no locks on doors. Whenever there's an incident, a student can be taken in there and is never left alone. So, yes, de-escalation rooms exist, but not seclusion rooms. Students are not to be left alone, much less locked up.
More like it looks like a jail cell.
Yeah, more like a zen zone as opposed to a cell.
Very different. Obviously, the beginning of this investigation, and we'll stay on it. Vicente, thank you.